Let's study some of the basic premises of how an image is formed from a 3D scene. We start off with just a simple representation of a 3D scene. We have a lens, and of course, because of this lens, now we know that we can actually create an image of this 3D scene on the other side of the lens. Here I'm basically just now showing you a simple paradigm where, again, a lens, all the light goes through the lens here, generates a 3D scene. And this is basically all of the light from this thing is now going through this lens and captured here. Most of the time, we will actually be putting a sensor where we want to capture the image at the focal plane of a lens. So at f, distance away from the lens, we want to be able to capture the image. And this is where actually we want to be able to put our sensor. And that you'll see various examples on why that's important. Let's look at a few examples of what happens if certain things change in this image formation pipeline. Again, we have a 3D object, lens, and the image being formed at the focal point of this lens. So as I said, now I'm going to push the sensor, a film, or any form of a screen here that's going to be where we want to capture images. You may remember this was the concept that was there in the pinhole camera in the previous lecture too. We always wanted to create an image at the focal plane away from the lens. So what happens if I was to now move this tree further away from the lens? So everything else is the same. I've just moved the tree here. By doing simple geometry on this one, you will notice that when you take and trace the rays of light through the lens, a tree is formed on the image sensor, except that now, of course, it's much smaller. This is the image size here. Of course, it's much smaller on this side here. And that's valuable because, in essence, as I move the tree farther away, of course, it should look more distant. So this is exactly doing what we expect it to do. And if I had, let's say, two trees, one front and one in back, the further one should be looking smaller. So this is kind of giving me a sense of depth or perspective, which basically says things farther away will be smaller. Now let's look at what happens if I move the tree inwards. Same lens, same situation, same location of the sensor. And of course, if you just draw the rays of light and do the projection again, you will notice that this time the tree is bigger. So this tree is smaller, and of course, this tree is much bigger. And again, same example applies. It's closer to the sensor, therefore it appears to have more size and appears to be larger. So this just demonstrates that by changing distances of the object to the lensing system, the camera here, we can now actually see closer or farther off objects.